Previously on Surviving Sliptopia.
It's a power dispenser. To go ahead and hit him with lava and that will kill him, and then you can grab another one. I'm gonna take a look at the beacons that I have at the fortress and see if I think they're gonna light or not, if they're gonna light up the fortress. I really don't want that to happen, obviously. We don't want the fortress to catch fire and burn down. What is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here, and yeah, we're in default. We're in the default texture pack. We have the default clouds. I'm pressing control. We do not have Optifine because I'm playing the new snapshot, the 1.4 pre-release. You can see it up there, and my texture pack's not updated, so I don't have all the stuff and things that I need in order to make it work. What is that? Dun dun dun. So I stuck an anvil up there. Yeah, I've been playing around with the new snapshot, and we got a lot of stuff to talk about. But first, what I thought we would do is look at this efficiency for Fortune 3 on Breaking 3. This is a pretty nice shovel. I think we should call it something. The Master Spoon. Should we do it? So it's 37 levels. To go ahead and, oh, the Master Spoon, there it is. So, probably the best spoon that I've got so far, and it only costs 37 levels to repair it. I've been playing around a little bit with how the anvil works, and it is kind of interesting. What's this? Dun dun duh! So I already got a potato and a carrot from hanging out here at the spawner. This is all the armor that we got last time we were here, but I came back to the Falcon's Boot, been hanging out. Look at this guy's got gold armor. Let's take him out. They're harder to take out because they have armor. It's crazy town. Look at all these guys. I didn't realize I let it build up that much. It actually feels like the spawner's a little bit more efficient. It's always strange when you put a snapshot or an update in, because things change that you just wouldn't think would change, like spawn rates. So, did we get anything cool? I didn't drop his cool armor. But, yeah, so that's the stuff and things that have been happening over here. I don't have an update for the texture pack yet. 1.4 for John Smith probably won't be out until 1.4 is out, or a little bit after that. I'm not sure why they don't start doing work on the texture packs beforehand, especially considering the pre-releases here. But as of today, it hasn't. So some other things that we wanted to talk about. First of all, I like the new sound of when you fall into the water. There are some new sounds that I do like, and there are some new sounds that I do not like. But, yeah. So there's the fortress, and there's one of the signal fires, and it doesn't seem to be burning down the fortress. I was a little afraid. Hold on a second. Let's... That's such a weird thing. Did you hear it? Such a weird noise. So I was a little afraid to upgrade to the snapshot because I thought I was going to have to come back here and put all my fires out. Fire spreads much more easily now than it ever did before. Actually, it spreads more like it used to back in the day. It is really weird to view my world in the default texture pack. I'm not a huge fan of it, but yeah, I was worried that the signal fires would burn my fortress down, and my buddy Drax from Drax LP did a video response and was nice enough to load the snapshot. Go ahead and get the world download for Sliptopia. You can grab it in the channel description of my YouTube page, yeah, it was nice. He went in, did some testing for me, and he showed that the fires weren't going to burn stuff down. So thank you very much, Drax. It was really cool of you to do that. I was like super impressed. I was like, this is awesome, super helpful, and it was just really rad. But now we have anvils. Now we need, with anvils, I guess some chunk loading issues have started from 1.4. We need a lot more XP now. And so it's time, I think, to do some things, you know? Some things. Stuff and things. See, those are vents. Those are supposed to be vents. They're vents in my texture pack. But it's time to do some stuff and things to ensure that we get some more experience. But yeah, this is the fortress. I think most of you guys have seen this stuff by now. We'll talk about it more in the world tour, the 1,000 sub special. But I'm going to head back to the canvas and kind of show you guys more about what I've been working on, probably in the regular texture pack, in the good texture pack, and I'll see you guys over there. So I've been working hard on the villager breeding stuff. Did a little bit more work on it, and I'm going to take you down and kind of show you a little bit more about what our plans are, and that's kind of what we're going to talk about today. We're going to talk more about just what the device is going to look like. And, yeah, I'm kind of excited about it. Wow, we got a lot of chunky issues going on, I think. I had a lot of questions in my mind about how I was going to build it. You know, I didn't know what it was going to look like. What up, playa? I didn't really know what it was going to look like, and I was a little bit kind of freaked about it because... That is so weird. The cloud completely obscures the top of the tower now. I cannot wait for Optifine in 1.4 and to have my texture pack back. But I cleaned stuff up down here quite a bit and started doing some work. So I don't think there'll be any mobs down here. There shouldn't be any mobs down here. Just in case we'll get the little get a bow ready to see what's up. But I got a lot more villagers in here now. All the derps are hanging out, being derpy, and so I can bring them out whenever I want, but what I wanted to do is start working on the breeding machine and see how the machine was going to work. And so I started hauling this out because it's going to be kind of big. It's going to be rather a large machine. So I kind of forgot, actually, that this stuff's all going to go, too. Let's just make an edging here so that I know what it is that needs to go. Where's the master spoon? The master spoon. Oh, is that it? But I'll leave the rest of that for later. I'll clear that out with some TNT, which is what I've been doing. It's actually, I think, kind of been, I think, it has been really fun to do this stuff because what I actually have been doing, let me see, I'll go down one more. Oh, crap, there's resources in here. I can't blow up all these resources. Let's see how big of a mess we make. I think this is going to be a big mess. I may want to stop using the TNT when I'm this close to the villager area. But that's kind of what I did, and that's how I cleared out this area. I don't know. You know, I was thinking a lot about it when I was doing it. I was like, is this any faster than just digging it? Yeah, I think I made a big mess up there. And I don't know if it was necessarily any faster because I was being really strategic. Yeah, not that bad of a mess, but a mess all the same. I was being very strategic with how I placed my TNT so that I wouldn't have any problems with kind of blowing up the areas I didn't want to blow up. And I think that because I was being so strategic, it was taking about the same amount of time as if I was to just dig it out. But it does save a lot on tool usage. So that is it's a good thing, you know. You don't want to waste your tools. So, yeah, think about that when you're building, getting your TNT on. Let me see here. I hope you guys liked and would love to get some feedback on the Chivalry episode that I put out yesterday. That was kind of I didn't really know. I wanted to get it out there because I think it's a thing. There's so much hype around that Chivalry game right now, and I kind of wanted to give you guys my opinion on it really quick. I should be able to... This should not cause any problems. Yeah. So, I wanted to get my opinion out there really quick for you guys so you could hear kind of what my thoughts were. The game's getting so much play on the Minecraft network, and I'm just not super impressed with it. It's fun, but I don't know. I mean, I don't know. So if you're on the fence, you can watch that. That video is the last video that I put out. But I have the machine finished. Although it is in its kind of raw form, it is ready to go in Testopia, and we can head over there and take a look at it. So this is what she looks like. This is just kind of a rudimentary holding cell for some derps with just some water to push them into the corners. And there's a derp in here right now. He's glitched down out of the area. But what I'll do is I have it set for trade. See if I can get him in there. This will move him over to the trading area, like so. And this is what the trading machine looks like. So right now, I think this is how it's pretty much going to work. These are doors to refill. This is how you're going to refill the all of the dispensers. And for now, I have paper in there. And I have it set on a timer. And I'm using one of the repeater locks here just as an on-off switch. So here's my my timer. I've got the timing. I was playing around with how kind of fast I want the trade to happen. And then this is just a repeater lock so that when I turn this on or off, you'll see that we get a sprouting of paper, a flourish of paper. So let me see if I throw this out of here. It should be 64 and 17. I got 27. I think maybe some of my guys have run out of paper. Have they? Did I have a hang up here? Where did the rest go? Oh, it must have gone into my inventory. So let's throw that away and get another piece here. I think it's 64 and 17 each time. And I have some ice in there, and it all rushes down. 64 and 16 this time. I think one of the dispensers has run out. And then what it will do is, if you leave this off, is that every so often it will send those out. So when you're trading, I have it set so it won't happen any faster than you're able to trade. So you're not going to waste any paper. And I think that's a good speed. So yeah, that's what it's going to look like, and I think it's going to be interesting to kind of fit it into the world. Just to save on lag a little bit, I put a switch in here so that you're able to turn off and on the water. So there's the water streams, and so yeah, you can get that on and off like so. And yeah, that's the switch for that. So that's kind of how that works. Now over here, what we have is we have a button here to send our cart back, to send our villager back when we're done with him. And then what I've done in order to kind of make this work in this confined space, I wanted to make this work with the existing design from Doc M. And so the thing that we needed to do was to make the trading machine work with these three spaces that we have for carts, and still have it be able to pick up a new villager. So I think that I'm going to need to spawn some more guys in here. So let me go ahead and cut out your whining. Get in there. So we'll have a bunch of villagers in there. They'll all be hanging and derping around. Let me get these guys here, shut this down. Come on. Come on, you can let me do it. Are you guys gonna let me do it? Oh, you know what? I got an idea. Better. And let's get some water back in there real quick. Alright, so now we have all of our derps, and they're sitting inside of here. And then we got this guy here, and he's got a book trade, and we don't like his book trade, so we'll go ahead and kill him. And that all works exactly the same way, but we have this recycle button, a recycle switch here, and once he dies, we'll be able to send the cart back through the exit rail. But what will happen is it will come up in this area, and it should pick up another villager. Oh, it didn't. That's good. That's perfect. Come on, do me a favor. Okay. Yeah, I'm glad I'm having this issue because I haven't had it in the past. And I have no idea why it's not picking up a villager. It has always picked them up in the past. There we go. So we got a guy, finally. It took a couple seconds. I could set up a switch right here so that, and I may need to do that, just so it simply comes back and forth. I'm not exactly sure why it's doing it that way. But I think that I may need to do a little bit of redesign once I get it into the real world. But this is kind of what it's going to look like. I think it's working pretty good. I'm kind of irritated that I had those problems. I hadn't had those problems in the past with it not picking up a villager. So I'm not quite sure exactly why it wasn't picking one up. But let me see if there's a better way that I can do this or think about it. Let's try it one more time and see what happens. Maybe it was a fluke. Oh. I have it on trade mode. No, this is getting really bad. Okay, I've just destroyed everything. Good. So, that was perfect. Yeah, you're laugh. Go ahead, laugh. It's funny. Yeah, real funny. So, we're on recycle mode now. It should work correctly. Oh my god, that's so irritating. Why aren't you picking up a guy? You always did it before. Alright, well evidently there needs to be a redesign. I'll work on that more. Wow, I'm really surprised that it's not doing it. Huh. So odd. Oh, wow. Never had a failure before. Not one time. Definitely not an efficient way to do it now. So I'll have to work on it and figure out a smarter way. Yeah, it'll look something like this when it's done. Let's go back to Sliptopian Hangout. Okay, I lied. I actually got really irritated by the fact that this wasn't working correctly. And I decided that I would fix it right now. So, oh yeah, this is all broken too. So sad. But it took me a second to kind of figure it out. And what I've done is built a pulse shortener for this. I tried hooking up the track selector directly to the button, but the pulse is too long. So what ends up happening is if I hook this up directly to the button, the track switches and stays switched so long that he moves off to the trade area. What I need is for this to switch the other direction for just enough time for the cart to get over to this side, and then once it's in this side, I need it to switch back. So what I did is built a pulse shortener. So here's a design of a pulse shortener. I looked up a couple online and I couldn't find any that I liked, so I just built this one. So what happens is the pulse comes down into this block, and then this same signal is carried over to the piston. So you'll see that this piston should stay on longer than that one. And that when this piston's engaged, it moves this block, which cuts off power to that piston. So it shortens the pulse. And so then I just built a pulse shortener of the same type over here and played with the timing a little bit until I got it to do this. We're on pickup. So now it works. And it picks a guy up. Let's go ahead and kill him. And then I just used a repeater lock here to shut it off to turn it into trade mode or not. So these repeater locks, I'm finding a lot of use for them. They're really quite cool. So go ahead, die. So we're in pickup mode now. And we got our villager. We'll hit trade mode. And bam, he goes off into the trade area over here, which I just have constantly powered to send them back. But yeah, so I'm sorry I didn't have that working the first time. I hadn't seen that issue, but this actually is really cool. Of course, I'll try to build it more compactly and it'll be underground and stuff like that. But for now, we have it working much better. And yeah, time to head back to Sliptopia. And we're back. So how many blocks do I have till I get to the edge? 1, 2, 3. So right here, if we stick some TNT, this should only destroy the blocks we want. Yep. And so I'm going to continue to work on this stuff. This is kind of the next thing, the next project that I'm going to be doing. I really want to get it completed. I take on a lot of these projects, and like I was talking about last week, or on Friday, it's sometimes tough because I want to get a lot of stuff done, but I do a lot of videos, so it's tough. So I'm going to start to try to work a little bit harder. These are too high. I'm going to have to just dig this out. I could TNT it, but I think this would be a little bit of a waste of TNT. But yeah, I'm excited to build the machine for true and for real, and have it kind of be down in this area. I'm psyched that I only need the single, like I don't have to have that big track return that I had in there. That big track return was fun and it looked really cool, but I think it's neat that we found a kind of a simpler way to do it. And we'll have a lot of space over here to hopefully to house all the electronics that we need, all the electronics, all the redstone, in order to make sure that, everything fits in the right way. But yeah, this is kind of what we're going to be doing. So, other than that, I don't really have any other updates for you guys. Life-wise, everything's been going good. I'm excited to do the 1,000 sub special. It should be coming up pretty quick. I said I was going to do something for Halloween too. I don't know if maybe I can fit them in together into one big, giant, enormous thing. But that might be fun as well. Now that we have bats and such, obviously, I mean, I don't want to, no spoiler, but there might be some bats in the Halloween special, go figure. I do have to take some time and make the other side of this identical, which is going to take a little bit of time. And I want to build everything twice here, so there's two trading machines completely. Is that lit up well enough? Nope. Let me get a couple more torches down here. I don't want any mobs to spawn. I'll eventually have the floor half slabbed out. But yeah, I think this is kind of neat that this comes down like this. I'll be able to put the machine in this area here, house the redstone that we need for the return track system in this area. It'll be cool that everything will be able to work off of this one button. Oh, I grabbed a guy. What kind of trade do you have? Emeralds for 4. Crappy trade! You are the weakest link. So, while I'm here, I have a good amount of villagers in here now. Let me see. About 20. And what I've just been doing is, while I work, I just been keeping them in humpy mode. Hump! See? They're in humpy mode. And it's pretty pretty amazing how quickly that they'll start to hump. And if I keep a bunch in there like that, if you keep 20, if all of them are ready to breed, within a couple of minutes, you know, you should see a bunch more. It's not as simple as saying there's 20 in there, they'll breed 30 instantly. Different guys get humpy at different times. The villager to humpy ratio changes a bit, but if you are building one of these on your own, definitely take some time to get a decent population in here so that it is a lot faster when you do get the humpy time. You get a lot more villagers a lot more quickly. Let me see. So we already got another single. But yeah, it's not necessarily as easy as saying there's 20 in there. They'll be, you know what I mean? They'll all breed and there will be 30 within just a moment, because this is not how it works. But let me see here. I have a lot of crap and garbage. There's gonna have to be a lot of storage down here too, so that'll be a contingency that we need to plan for. Just having a good amount. I'm making a big old mess. Just having a good amount of storage space for all the items that we're gonna be using for the trades and such. And I don't know if I'm gonna do. Yeah, I guess I'll just do like one at a time. I know that there's a trade for weapons. So there's a pix trade where you're able to trade for a working pix that are pretty decent. And I don't know, how did I, see now I don't remember how I did this. How did I build this over here? That's half slabs to stairs. How did I do it? Half slabs, okay. So I don't know if I'm going to need that working pick trade. Anvils kind of are a game changer. Anvils are really going to make it so that if you have a spawner, you just really don't need to be worrying about getting a lot of working items or working replenishing your tools at all. You can just use an anvil and repair them. And so it's kind of interesting that Mojang's decided to do that, because it always seems like... Oh, yeah. Come on, Master Spoon. Oh, this thing's awesome. Remember Flight of the Navigator? Death Blossom? And I am absolutely full. How do I even get out of here now? Oh my gosh. So, Mojang's made it now so that you just don't really need to worry about getting a lot of enchantments, or like enchanting a lot of things, because once you have kind of the set you want, you'll be able to repair them kind of indefinitely. Being careful that, you don't damage them too much. I'll probably end up getting some more levels and going back and trying to get this thing repaired even more very quickly, so that when I get it down to like 75% or something like that, I'll be able to take another spent spoon, or I don't know how it works. I'll have to play around with that. I'm not sure if you can add iron in there, or if it has to be... do I have fortune? Yeah, I do. I will actually silk touch these bad boys. I'm not sure if you can use iron on diamond, or if it has to be diamond on diamond, item humping only, or how it all is going to work. But I'm sure they're smarter men than me will figure all of that out for us, and Etho will have a video out about it yesterday. So I'm going to work on this stuff some more. I think that's going to be it for today, the Monday episode. I hope that you guys had fun hanging out. It's really cool to see everything come along, but I'm going to maybe make the episodes a little bit shorter and give me a little bit extra time to get other stuff done. That might be the compromise. There is definitely some glitching problems going on here. Better. So, yeah, I hope that you had fun hanging out. If you have any comments or suggestions, you want to say hello, give me a high five or a fist bump, please go ahead and leave a comment. Your comments are always appreciated. Love hanging out with you guys in the comment section. And if you like the video, please don't forget to hit a like. And if you want to help Sliptopia grow, you can share and favorite and tweet and retweet and re-Facebook and Facebook and re-blog post and Pinterest. And then you can go ahead and put it on Reddit. Or if you want, you can get it on BuzzFeed. And I don't even know. It's amazing and ridiculous the amount of things and stuff that you can put where you can put the link to a website these days. But I appreciate you guys helping out the channel, and I hope that you have a great rest of your day. K-I-A.